Oh yeah. Hey, what's up everybody? Yours truly, Trey Hardy here, aka the Trigger Trey from the good old Kill Instinct Squad. Today we're playing some more of that The Devil in Me, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Let's do this. Okay, where we left off, hold up. Okay, where we left off, we almost lost a character. I think her name was Erin. Looks like she survived. And we came into this room with these creepy ass dolls.
Okay, this is fucked up.
Yeah,
it is. What the hell is going on?
Please don't turn your head. This would be the perfect time to just leave. Don't turn your head. Don't turn your head. I'm not going to be scared if you do it because I'm kind of expecting it.
Jesus. It looks just like him.
Yeah, this Dumet guy is weird.
Just threw these together in the last couple of hours.
Right now, I'm convinced the real killer is the real Dumet.
You hear that?
Footsteps.
And they're getting closer.
Uh-oh.
Watch out.
Uh-oh. Hopefully it's one of our people. I think it's one of our people. Woo!
Jamie!
Almost smacked a bitch. If it wasn't.
I'm so glad to see you guys. We have to get the hell out of here.
Let's go probing. What happened?
What happened when the wall closed?
Demet killed his groundskeeper.
What?
Right in front of us. Demet? It's a setup. He was wearing a mask, and I know how that sounds, but I'm not joking, and now he's after Erin, so we need to move.
Yeah, I think Dumet was the limo driver at the beginning.
No, we got separated. No way this is happening.
You know, so when our bodies wash up on the other side,
are you fucking kidding me?
Bodies dead.
Jesus, shut it up!
Bodies dead. 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 Dead.
What was that?
Oh, shit. That's an actual eyeball.
It's fake. A prop, or from an animal or something. It has to be.
No, 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 no way.
That's an eyeball.
Oh! Oh, it's real. It's fucking real. I told you, this was all too much. Let's get out of here. It's locked. What's going on? The door I came through is locked too.
Dumet! You wanna play around?
Get out here. Right now. Let's fucking play!
Be careful what you ask for, homeboy. Uh-oh. I forgot he fell down a shaft or something.
Uh-huh. Oh, shit.
Oh. The hill? We have to pick it up again. He just burned himself. Cage key. Anything else in here?
Jamie! Hello! Jamie!
Can I jump up there? I don't trust that cage door. Can I jump up there? Okay, they didn't let me jump up there, so check this out. I don't trust this door. Got a nice little a log book. Alright. Just a bunch of names of people. The fuck is this covered in bloodstains? Okay, that's important. Okay, so they just up and left.
What? What the hell was that?
Yeah, what the hell was that? Abdominal injuries. Victim's ears were removed by severely sharp object. Oh, shit. Let me get the other picture.
John Doe, number two. I'm assuming you've read my report on the first one? Similar MO, unidentified male with multiple stab wounds. Looking at the lower abdomen, the wounds are consistent with those of the first victim. The shape of the entry wound suggests it's a strong probability that this is the same murder weapon. Looks like we've got a souvenir hunter here. This time the left ear has been severed.
Oh!
Clean incision. Probably a scalpel or a razor blade.
Oh!
Very tidy. Nice job, actually. Very little bleeding. The deceased had probably been dead for 30 to 40 minutes when this was done. This differs from the earlier MO. If you remember, that John Doe was still alive when the teeth were removed.
Oh, that's gonna hurt.
Created a lot of noise and mess. This guy is learning.
I haven't seen any dark pictures in a while. Clues to a premonition. Examine. Guess we're gonna examine. I have a bad feeling about this.
fell down the trap tonight. What if I get out? I'll send someone back for you.
Okay, that's just creepy. You're talking to a Kindle. I'll take it this opens that door. There's something there, and there's also something here. Okay, so there's someone spying on me, probably Dumit. Anything in here? I don't see anything. I like how you can jump over stuff and slide through things. It's definitely an improvement over the last few Man and Medan games. Not Man and Medan, Dark Pictures. Alright, got one of those coins. Anything else over here? Well, this don't... I have a bad feeling about this. Do I have a lighter? Something on the ground. Oh, the little Kindle burnt. What's this?
Well, hello.
Got some cigarettes. What's going on? Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
doing?
Oh no. Tell me that's not gas. I'm in a fucking incinerator. A furnace, something.
Hey! Hey, hello! I'm here!
Oh, fuck. Shit. I gotta find a way out of here. I don't think the door's any good since the killer's right there. But how am I getting out of here? Can I climb up? I gotta find a way out of here. I couldn't reach that thing on the other side of the door anyway. Maybe the crate? Wait, I got up a little bit. We got up a little bit. Let's try that again. Come on, come on, come on. Okay. There we go. Hopefully this works. Wait. Nah, he getting cooked.
Things are starting to heat
oh,
up.
Oh, the curator.
Charlie's goose. Maybe cooked.
Maybe.
Mark and Kate clearly want to be truthful.
Oh, thank God.
But it turns out that Kate has been hiding something from Mark, maybe even trying to hide it from herself. And how do we feel about Mr. Dumet's lovely animatronics? I think they're rather clever. Some of them look very realistic. I wonder where he sources the parts. It would only be fair at this stage to offer up a little hint to even the odds. What do you think?
Yeah, I'll take one.
Let's take some inspiration from the works of Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. Apparently, our friend Herman Mudgett was so enamored with Sherlock Holmes that he borrowed his surname. Here. He has a brain of the first order. He sits motionless, like a spider, in the center of its web. But that web has 1,000 radiations, and he knows well every quiver of each of them. I hope that helps.
You're speaking in riddles. I don't know what the hell you just said.
Better get back to things. Best of luck.
Yeah, I think Charlie got cooked, but the curators did say maybe. So maybe he survived. There's no confirmation he's dead.
I could have saved him.
We're on a little cliffhanger right now. There's no confirmation of Charlie's dead or alive.
Aaron. No way.
Damn it.
It's another trap.
It's the only way out of here. So we're going to find out.
Alrighty, this is Trey Hardy here from the good old Killer Instinct Squad. I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. So what we're leaving off is that Charlie may or may not be alive. I don't know. The curator always pops up when a character is about to die. There's no confirmation that Charlie is dead. So we're going to leave that on a cliffhanger until next episode. If you've been watching this video, make sure you thumbs up, you know, leave some feedback, talk to us, and subscribe, and see you in the future on some more epic gaming adventures. Peace.